12 o'clock on a Wednesday, and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
And on this week's show, first of all, we've got String Theory by Vince Mendoza. Can you describe the effect, first of all, Sean?
The effect, it's basically a gypsy thread type effect, but with a different method than the one that you all know at home, and it's close-up rather than stage. Is that fair enough?
Yeah, and what sort of happens? Describe the process that he goes through.
He tells a little story about the bit of string being about life.
Yeah.
And how different bits of the string as he cuts up represents a different part of life. So he has several bits of string that he's cut up in front of the spectators. He then puts a different string, which represent different parts of your life, into the spectators' hands. He does a little bit of magic, and he pulls them apart, and just like that, the string's restored back to one.
Gypsy thread is a fantastic piece of magic. It really is a fantastic piece of magic, isn't it?
In fact, we just watched a YouTube video.
Yeah.
And we watched probably the best performance of Gypsy Thread that I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah, absolutely.
It could go into anybody's routine and make it whether you're a comedy
magician. I'm going to steal it.
Yeah. Whether you're a comedy magician, if you're a big stage illusionist like the guy that we watched, you know, no matter what sort of magic you're doing, a good Gypsy thread is amazing.
Gypsy Thread is a great piece of magic. This isn't. This is awful. This really is an awful piece of magic. It's got everything missing from it, which is great about Gypsy Thread.
Mm-hmm.
Gypsy Thread, it's almost like a piece of art. It's so artistic when you perform it.
It's so simple. We were talking about the video, which we'll talk about later, of the guy that we saw performing it on stage.
Yeah.
And that moment where you've got a little bubble in the middle and you pull it apart, and it's that bubble's right in front of your face. Like Jeffrey Durham talks about this in his lecture. It's right in front of your face, so the audience are watching you because that's who they're interested in, and it restores itself. It's brilliant. The spotlight on the stage, nice yellow thread, perfect.
I've got so many problems with this. First of all, from a routine concept, the scissors for a start. What bloody hell is going on? You've got a pair of scissors. It's like, oh, let's get all the stuff out. You know, let's have scissors. It's not an arts and crafts project. You're doing a magic trick.
If you're going
to... And now you've got to have a pair of scissors and you're doing this and you're doing...
If you're going to... But put it this way.
You need to use the string you get with it.
Yeah.
And I'm guessing that you can't break this by your hand, so you have to use scissors. I don't like the scissors.
Well, the thing is, if you're going to need scissors, at least do a proper bit of rope.
Yeah.
You know, do cutting with stored rope if you're carrying around a big pair of scissors.
Which is more visual. The best thing about Gypsy Thread is the fact that it is just one piece of thread. The bits never leave your side with the normal Gypsy Thread.
That's right.
That doesn't happen with this.
Mm-hmm.
They go out of your sight for a long time, actually. And I think if a spectator was really burning you and really taking a look at this, I think they might say, something happened there.
They know something happened there. There's a bit of a giveaway of what's happened with the string, which even on the demo of the video, on their trailer, you can see the bit where you see the thing that's happened on the string, can't you? You can actually see it.
What you're talking about there, you're talking about the restoration.
Yeah.
Again, I've got another problem with this. It's such a beautiful moment with the Gypsy Thread. The way you said, the way it unravels.
That's the magic. That is the magic.
That is the moment. That's the money shot. And yet, what do? They've got all this slow, trying to be artistic build-up that's kind of like a poor imitation of Sean's video that we saw. And it's kind of like cut up, puts it in their hand, and then it's like, wham!
It's weird.
And it's just like, bang! And you could blink, you could miss it. And it's more like a bar stunt.
Oh, it's not anything.
It's more like, I've wrapped this round your finger three times and look, it comes through.
It's the type of thing Uncle Bill will show you at the Christmas party. And
it's got about that much. It's got the Uncle Bill finesse level
rubbish,
at the end,
rubbish,
the way
rubbish.
It's actually restored.
It's awful. It's the worst. The YouTube trick. Can we talk about this?
Well, I just want to stay on this just for a moment. Before we get onto the patter, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
That's the trick itself when you get there. Do you want to talk about preparation time
this? You're talking hours. Is it an hour?
Oh,
and you have to do it.
Felt like it.
This isn't a trick like a Sans Mind one where you make it once and you've got the gimmick forever. Every time you want to perform this trick, you've got to do this preparation. So if you want to do it three times at a gig, you've got 6 hours worth of 6 hours with the preparation time or whatever, haven't you? I'm not joking you.
You need set it up in card and, oh, it's just awful.
And the effect is rubbish.
And
the routine
it's not
is
as
rubbish.
Strong as the original Gypsy Thread. I don't know what they're selling here. It goes out of your sight. The method's not as good. The restoration is not as good. The only thing they could be selling is the fact that it happens in their hands. But, like we said, you could just put it straight into spectators' hands.
Yeah, gypsy thread, you pull it all apart, you hang the little bobble off the short piece of string, you get, if you're doing it close up, like this is a close up trick, you give one person to the person on this side, one end to the person on this side, they pull it apart slowly and it still happens in this area here.
Yeah.
None of this weird bit where you're having to bend over them and go like that.
Yeah.
It's awful.
You said as well, I've seen this before, this is like the patter Sean Farquhar uses, and we put that video on, and it's
even
very much the same.
It's even got some of the same phrases in it.
Yeah.
They've even left some of the same. We can't obviously go out and say they definitely copied this from Sean Farquhar. The routine
Farquhar.
The routine is incredibly similar to Sean's, isn't it?
Yeah.
And they've got some of the same phrases in there, you know, that right at the beginning of the routine. The routine's the same concept as well.
There's no emotion, there's no heart, there's nothing.
Is there a gimmick in there, or is this what you're getting?
That's what you get.
You're buying string as well.
And how to do a naff trick with that string.
Do you know, this is like, go back 100 years when somebody went, let's invent gypsy thread. This is the method that they might have come up with first, and then somebody went, no, you know what, there's a better way of doing that. And it's evolved to the great trick that we've got today with gypsy thread. This...
That was good. And how much are you going to give it?
Not. Apps minus one, actually. Minus 1%.
I'm going to give it nothing as well. I think it's awful. I'm surprised at the people involved with the project. The method behind it's tipped in kids' magic books. Yeah, it's a little bit more advanced, but yeah, not impressed at all. And it's taken one of my favourite effects and destroyed the magic in it. Mm-hmm. It's time for
Under the Shell, Under the Shell, Under the Shell.
What is
Under the Shell?
Right, let's make the call. First ever Under the Shell. We put it on Facebook. Michael is going to answer. Michael is in America. That's you, John.
Hello.
There's Michael.
Hey Michael from America.
How you doing? You all right? Michael, you were the first one, first ever contestant ever on Under the Shell.
Under the Shell.
Do you know what you got to do? Let me just flip this around so you can see. There we go. Can you see that? Hang on. That's the back camera, isn't it? There we go. It needs to put it on
the front camera.
There's the front shells. Right. First of all, Michael, you have to answer the qualifying question. You might need to get closer so we can pick this up, John. You have to answer the qualifying question. Can you name three different methods, three different tricks that have a clear box in them?
Sure. There's the Clarity Box.
Yep.
By David Riddle.
Yep.
60 by Wayne Dobson.
Yep.
And my personal favorite.
Very good.
Mystery Solved.
Awesome. Yeah.
Wow. I thought he was going to say the Clear Subtrunk.
We could have had Clear Subtrunk or any of those, but we're pleased you went for those. That's great. Right. So it's Under the Shell. This one is number one. This one is number two. We've got it, and this one is number three. Let's keep it all on a wide shot, John, so we're not accused of cheating. It's your turn now to play Under the Shell, Michael. You've got to choose one of those shells, and the contents is yours. There's an okay prize, there's a good prize, and there is a great prize. So it's one, two, or three. What are you going to go for?
Let's go with number three.
Number three, right. Let's first of all show you what you could have won.
You could have won... A sponge tooth!
A sponge tooth, pretty good.
To go with your Alan Wong sponge poo.
Right, okay. Number two.
It is the little hand.
The original little hand. The original and the best little hand. And number three...
Ta-da!
It is actually a mystery solved. So you've won a mystery solved.
Not a subtrunk.
Not a subtrunk. It's the mystery solved. That's what's under there. So that is winging its way to you in the United States.
Wow.
Dave in the office will give you a call back and get all your details. Thanks very much. The first ever contestant at
Under the Shell. Under the Shell. Under the Shell.
What is
Under the Shell?
What's in the box? What's in the box? What's in the box? What's in the box?
Introduce every review now like that.
Yeah.
Think of a song. What is in the box? Have a guess. What's in the box?
Is it an Alan Wong tooth?
Do you want to get it off the sticks, John, so you can have a look at this? Because you won't believe
what
is inside here.
Is it a secret?
What?
There nothing. Is actually nothing inside that box. Is and it? They can check it out like that. And that's it. That's kind of all it does. And they can check that out and examine it. So what do you think to that? It's called the secret box. What did you think to that, John?
I think it's quite good. I think it's good. To do that at Christmas or something like that with the family, brilliant.
Yeah, you really upset some kids. You know, they think they're going to get a sweet off you. Guess what Uncle Sean's got in the box, kids? Oh, sweet. Sweet, let's have a look at... Ooh, let's have a look at the box. Nothing. You got nothing, you stupid child. You're brilliant.
What do you think to it?
I think...
Now, tell the truth. What happened when you first came in?
I'm not going to tell the truth. Oh, dear. Don't break it. I think the thing is, here was a trick that will definitely fool people. I'll tell you why. Because it fooled me. Right? But is it entertaining? Or is it just a classic example of what I just said, going, you're a stupid spectator, you are. You know, it's like, I know how the trick's done, you don't know how it's done.
I think you need a gag, like, if it was part of, like, a ring routine, and then you say, I've got this bottle, you're not going to believe what's inside here.
Yeah.
Nothing. Yeah. No, I said you wouldn't believe what's inside. Nothing. There is nothing. You can check it. Then they're looking at that, and then...
When they're doing that, that's when you can then load the ring into
whatever. Do whatever you're going to do.
Your misdirection, yeah. As a standalone trick, it's a cool puzzle for kids. You can have great fun with, you know, doing that with them, and then... You know, not actually giving them a present or anything.
And you can open it quite cleanly. You can show it. You definitely hear something inside. The sound is coming from this as
well. Oh, yeah.
It's not coming from up your sleeve or somewhere like that.
Okay, so here's the thing, David.
The sound
is
definitely coming
from this.
Why
would I buy that if I could strap a matchbox to my sleeve with something in it and just do it with that anyway?
Because then it's all self-contained. But I know what you're saying. That is a method.
What if you
want to
do it on the beach?
In Cancun, John came there. He sent his calendar.
You could strap it somewhere else, couldn't you?
No, I disagree.
You do. You can tell, and you can go like that.
Right, you could do that with a matchbox on your.
No, not that.
Not
well.
With your sleeve rolled up.
The matchbox doesn't sound tin.
It's good. That,
all right, a
you're
tin.
Right. You are right.
Put a tin on your arm then.
But you knew that was coming from that today. When I
did know that
you.
Was coming from that,
and you were fooled because I was able to go like that, and the thing is,
it fools people.
When
fools
you
people.
Open it. And you show nothing, the heat is off it then.
Yeah.
Because then you can shake each bit, there's no sound.
Yeah, it's empty.
And then if you want to clean up straight after that...
You can.
You're cleaning up actually on the offbeat because you've completely showed the inside of it at that point. I don't know how I'd use it, but it works.
Well, you'd use it like you said. If you wanted to go for that gag, you know where people make a pack of cards disappear and they go, and you never guess where they are, have a look in your left trouser pocket.
Yeah.
It's that gag. You give them that to start with, they hold it, or you put it near their wine glass, you make the ring disappear. Wouldn't it be amazing if that ring was out in that box?
Yeah.
Have a listen. Oh, look, it's not there. I told you it would, you know. And then you move on with your routine. That's maybe how you'd use it.
I don't know how. My problem with this is I don't know how I'd use it, but it works. And it's actually quite a good method.
It is quite. It's a trick, but it's not. It's not a trick in itself. It's not
a
trick in itself. It's a bit of business for the right person. I'll tell you what it is. There'll be somebody out there who's got a routine that's got a laugh missing from it or something that's going to go, well, I've got a use for that. It's that type of trick. You're not going to buy it as, I'm thinking of buying some random magic thing this week.
How much are you going to give it?
Do you know, I'm not going to do it, but it works and it fooled me. Right?
Yeah.
So it's, you know, 79%. And it's cheap, John said, as well.
I was going to say, how much is it?
About 12, not
a lot. It's a budget trick, but it's simple, and the method's actually quite good. You can be looking at it, and you can't see how it's done, Sean.
It will fool people.
I'll give it, like, 70%, but, yeah, it's good. If you've got a use for it, I'd give it more, but the method's good. Mm-hmm. Good method. To start with, to demonstrate this, we're going to get Sean to shuffle the cards. And John, we should probably get this off the sticks as well. So you shuffle the cards?
I certainly have.
Give them a mix-up. And you put those down just there. We're going to use these as well. And
what are those?
These are like little medallion things.
Medallion things.
Prediction medallions.
You've thought about the pattern on this statement, haven't you?
Let me read it.
What do they do on their drink? These are, ladies and gentlemen, I'm here at your table tonight to perform the mystery of the medallion prediction paddles.
Randomly selected by the spectator. Right. Okay.
Welcome to the convoluted magic show. This is a problem with magic now. Right.
Right. Put them down. Put them down. Don't touch those. They're sacred talismans.
Talismans?
Yeah.
What's a talisman?
I don't know.
If anybody knows what a talisman is, write it below now.
Take the cards.
Yeah.
Deal a pile, as many cards as you like. Keep going. Keep going. One pile.
Until I feel the power of talisman.
If you want, you can put some clumps down of cards. Clumps? A few more. You tried to be clever, didn't you?
It was the power of the talisman. I'm doing one more card and then we're done.
Right, okay. Now, take these cards. Now, this is completely random. You shuffle them.
Yeah.
And I want you to deal two hands of cards. So you keep going, alternating.
Alternating forever.
Yeah, so you keep going until you've exhausted all the cards.
Oh, they're not exhausting yet, but they're looking pretty tired.
Keep going.
Look at them angels. Right. Oh, crap, that way. On their bikes, look at them going.
Good?
They look exhausted to me.
Right, so you shuffled cards.
I did shuffle cards.
You dealt down as many cards as you liked.
I dealt down as many cards as I liked.
This is completely random, these two top cards, yeah?
These two cards are completely random,
but
yes.
We'll make it even more random.
How are we going to do that, David?
Right, first of all, let's look at these cards.
Yes, let's look at them.
Got black 2 and a red 3.
Yes.
The talismans.
The talismans.
One has a circle.
The talismans of doom.
One has a circle, one has a square.
One does have a... Pick well up, spotted.
Pick up anyone you like.
Yes.
And place it on top of the card, right in the middle.
Right on the middle of the card.
Yes.
Like this.
That's it.
Is that right?
Yeah. And put the circle on the other one.
There we go.
Now, I'm going to give you a chance to change your mind, because I'd hate for you to be going home today, Sean.
With the same mind I've got now.
I could have changed my mind. Do you want to change your mind?
No, I'm happy with the one I've got.
Cool.
Ba-dum-tsh.
That's been there all the time.
It has been there all the time.
All the time. It's
all the time it's been there.
It's like a prediction that's been in full
should
view.
Should you have told me there was a prediction
all
the time?
I probably should have mentioned that, actually.
And then maybe the whole talisman thing
especially
would have made a bit more
especially
sense.
As it's black on black, so you probably couldn't see it that well. So
The problem is when a black thing goes on a... Yeah, it's a big problem.
Right,
though,
so go.
Here go we what? Go. What am I doing?
Look, inside...
OMG!
The prediction matches perfectly.
Look
at that. Look, that's actually cut out as well.
There's actually a hole in there. So
there's actually a hole, and that is actually a hole just there. That is prediction.
That is prediction. It is correct.
Right. Do you know what I like about this? I know you don't like it as much.
Can I tell you what I like about
it? Right, I kind of started, then you butted in, so I'll start first. Right, so what I like about it, I think it's a good trick anyway. Right, I think it's a good trick just to, you know, you say get a couple and they find a matching pair or something like that. I think it's a good trick. But I think these add a certain permanence to it. Yeah. The fact that it makes the method stronger. It's got a separate step to it because they can put the talisman on any card they like. They can put it on anyone and it will match. And I also like the prediction cards, the fact they have a hole in. Once again, it's just something that can't be changed. It's got that permanence to it. I actually think this is a really strong yet simple trick. I think this is really good. I would do this.
Do you know what I think about this?
Go on.
Right. I really like the original effect that's performed here. I don't know the specific name of it, but the what it's based on.
Gemini Twins, is it?
Is it Gemini Twins?
Is it
Twins?
That? I don't know.
I don't think
so. You know
so.
Me, I don't read that much.
Yeah, but that original effect, I've seen it performed to lay people. I like it, but I like it as a... Oh, we've just got a pack of cards here. Can you show me something extra? Or if you've got a borrowed pack of cards, I like that routine, right? I think these adding to it, does it make the effect stronger? It does make the effect a little bit stronger.
Yeah, it does.
But David, let me ask you the defining question about this trick. Are you going to put that in your pocket with these and walk around at a gig and do it?
Do you know what? The answer to that is no, because we're talking about walking around at a gig.
Correct.
But I think it's one of those moments where, like in a parlour show, you're leading into a mind-reading trick. I think you could use this as a bridging trick to get somebody out, try something, do something quick, and then go on to something else.
Would you?
Seriously, I like it. I like how it looks. I like the charms or whatever they are. Obviously, it's got to have a better presentation.
It's convoluted magic. It's props for the sake of having props involved, and these make no sense, and that makes no sense.
Sometimes, though, if you're doing a show, you need the variety. You need it to change shape every now and then. You need to introduce props that aren't necessary from a magical point of view, but I think they're necessary from a production point of view. They make it interesting to look at for the spectator. And you've got to agree, Sean, when you did that, when you go like that at the end, and you open that, we know how this thing works, of course we do, but when you do that, there is something quite shocking about that imagery. And it was only when I started to do it, and I went like that, and remember, they can change either one of those if they want to. But when you go like that and you drop that down and they see it match perfectly.
Is it, or is there too much going on there? Would
it's perfectly balanced.
Is there, or would just a prediction of a two of spades and a three of hearts be just as impressive to a spectator?
Because that's the bit that'll torture them on the way home. I could have put it anywhere. Yeah.
I can't get my head round that adding to it. I know it looks kind of nice, but I personally can't get my head round that.
No, it's fair enough.
Watch the trailer and you might change your mind.
I've watched it.
You were just staring at that bird on there all the time. How much good
this is the one where it's like proper actors, isn't it? The trailer where it looks like you're going to watch some sort of Steven Spielberg film afterwards. Yeah. It's a
seriously, I know there's going to be people out there that say, I can't see it, but I actually really do like this. I like it because it's simple, but I think the reveal is strong, and I think it's got a certain level of permanence to it, which makes it more impossible. I would go out and try this. I think it's a great trick for a residency as well. I would give this 90%.
Really?
Yeah, I'm giving it 90%. I like it. I think it looks quality with the things as well.
It's
not a lot, is it, John?
No, it's like £15. And anyway, so a person at school could do this. They could have a picture on their phone, the two pictures, and just carry just the two discs around. And
brilliant.
Borrow a pack of cards. You still got that effect.
I know, just go to school and borrow a pack of... Has anybody in my... Anybody in class 2B got a pack of cards I can borrow?
I know what you're... I know you don't like it. How much are you going to give it? You don't hate it, do you?
I don't hate it.
Like the original trick?
I like the original trick. I just don't think it really adds anything to it. The trick works. The new method is a method. It 62%.
I'd rather do that than that bloody string theory.
Well, that got 0%.
Yeah, exactly.
So that's 62% better.
All right. That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. We've got to say that next week we will be taking a break from the Wizard Product Review because it's Christmas Eve.
We've also got a competition.
What competition is that?
My new competition.
Your new competition.
I've got, if anybody, right, the first person that spots the next product review show to have...
That's not going to take long. There's loads of them out there.
But the next one to have a dog on it, the person who spots it wins a prize.
All right, okay. Yeah.
Yeah, we'll is that a competition?
Yeah, we'll do a prize. They've got to have a dog on it.
They've got to have a dog on it, yeah.
So
when there's a copycat show that has a dog on it...
Yeah.
Then, well, if they spot them, the first one to have a dog, then they'll get a prize.
You're just putting a challenge out there to every other show
now. I'm putting a challenge out there to every other show.
First one to have a dog on.
Yeah.
You're going to send them a prize.
You're going to send them a prize.
Are you going to send the show a prize? Or the person who spots it?
Let's send the show a prize.
Right. From Blammo.
From Blammo, yeah. made by Alan Wong.
Yeah, but maybe smelling slightly different. That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. We'll see you next year, maybe. Or before.
Maybe.
That's it. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
See you next week.